After your tubes have spun down, then you can push this latch right here and open the centrifuge. Release the latch on the centrifuge lid. And then you're going to take the tubes out in the exact order that you put them in and set them up. So we're going to read the A tube first, take them directly out of the centrifuge over to your agglutination viewer, where I'll show you several techniques for tapping and grading your reactions and what to look for as you resuspend the button. We'll take the A tube, the first tube we set up, and we'll bring it over to the agglutination viewer. And you'll have the button down for this particular technique, the first technique. And you'll just, down means right down towards the mirror, as you see here. And then you're going to give it a little jiggle and a roll, just like this. And you're going to see the cells streaming down. I'm going to change the technique just a little bit so you can see what I'm talking about. You can see the button up there in the corner, and you can see the cells starting to stream down from the button. And you just really watch the button as you're tapping the tube. Until the cells are completely off the bottom of the tube. Then you stop. Once the cells are completely off the button, then you can give it a little shake and roll the cells down the tube. And you can see here that it's a nice negative result here. As soon as you have read a tube, then you want to record the result on your result sheet right away. So don't save up your reactions and try to remember what they were. So we're going to show you the second one, a little slightly different technique. In this one, you're going to have the button just up into the corner a little bit like this. And then give it a jiggle and a roll. And you can see the cells starting to stream off the button here. And I'm just going to change my technique a little bit to show you that a little easier. Can see the cells coming off the button here now, and just the saline swirling over the button. That's really what you want to have, is that continuous running of the saline over the button. And then when the cells are completely off, you can roll the reaction down into the tube like this, and you can see again that it's a nice negative reaction here, no agglutinants. If you see a few fine clumps that seem to come off at the beginning, that's probably fibrin, and you can ignore that. And then you record that result. So now we'll go on to the third one. And I'll show you a third technique, a slight modification of the last one that I showed you. Again, we're going to have the button just rolled up a little bit into the corner. And then you just want to gently brush the bottom of the tube with your middle finger or your ring finger. And you focus on the button. One of the disadvantages of this method is you do not want to tap too hard. Be real gentle. Let the position of the button do the work for you. You can see that the cells come off the button quite quickly with this technique. And the cells are completely off the button now, and we can roll the reaction down into the tube, and you can see it's a nice negative reaction here. We'll record that reaction and go on to the next tube. is the D typing. And this is a technique that works well for left-handed. We're going to put the button completely over on the other side, opposite the mirror, and a jiggle and rolling it down like this. And you can see that the button now is off the bottom of the tube, and it's a nice smooth reaction. So you see this nice smooth reaction there. That's a nice negative. And record the result for your D tube. Okay. Then we always have to read the D control. I will continue reading the rest of these tubes with the third method that I've shown you, since it shows up the best on camera. So here's the D control, and you can see the cells swirling off the button here, nice and smooth. Reminds me of a comet's tail. And there they're off, and it's a nice negative reaction. Record the result for the D control. So some labs will use zeros for negatives. Use a double dash. Now we'll do the first reverse tube, which is the A tube. And what would you expect on this with these results? Yeah, you'd expect positive. So let's see what we have here. Again, I'm going to roll the button just up into the corner a little bit. Some people have trouble seeing the button in this position. In that case, then you can use one of the other alternatives that I showed you, where the button is a little more visible to you. And so we're just going to tap it a few times here, and there it came off all in one piece. That's a 4+. And then the last two, we would expect positive on this one as well. So go, and we'll give it a little tap. Now this one you can see is a little weaker reaction. In fact, actually it looks like we're getting just a little chunking off the button. This is a quite a bit weaker reaction. It looks like a 2+. See the agglutinants there? So if this was any weaker, we'd have to repeat it. And record the result for the second reverse tube, the B tube. It was a weaker result. It was a 2+. And this concludes the ABO and Rh testing procedure with the demonstration of agglutination and reading and tapping the tubes. And we will continue on with the interpretation of our results. Okay, to begin the interpretation, we look at the cell testing and look at the group. You can see that anti-A and anti-B and anti-AB are all negative. So that would be an O for the forward group, and we'll record that right here. The D typing under the cell testing, you can see type, and you can see that the anti-D and the D control are both negative. So we can't actually interpret the Rh at this point. We're not sure of the Rh status of the patient because the anti-D is negative. It could be a weak D or DU that does not show agglutination at this room temperature procedure. So we'll need to take it on to the DU or weak D typing, which we will do in just a few minutes. The rest of the interpretation is the reverse group. And so we look under serum testing, And the group here, you can see that the A1 cell is a 4+, the B cell is a 2+. They're both positive, so that confirms the O. And we'll record that result right here. Now, you can see that the 2+ result for the B cell is weaker than the result for the A1 cell. It's a 2+. If it's a 2+ or greater, that is a valid result. However, if it was less than a 2+, if it was a 1+, we would not be able to interpret the reverse group. We would leave it blank. And we would call that a low titer or weak titer, which you can see with an elderly person or an infant. But in this case, it is 2+ or greater, and we can record the reverse group as an O.